is February, and look at this weather. Yesterday at this time we had about 6 inches of snow on the ground. And then we had the southern wind coming all the way up here to Michigan, and those 6 inches of snow that were here yesterday, totally gone now. There's a little bit left right there in that pile, but it's not much at all. So I'm out here trying to do what I can. It's a little, well, it's actually a lot soft, so I'm not going to do a whole lot with the Bobcat and trying to move these piles yet, because I'll just sink. See those ruts over there? I got to get rid of those ruts before I put those down. So I'm going to wait for a cold morning and go in there and back blade all that flat. Then I can get all the mulch on top of there and then start working on my fence. But look at this, Friday, it's great. I mean, February, sorry. Saturday, I forgot the date. But, yep, back to it. Got all my seeds, got all the seeds purchased last week while it was cold. And let's see here. The fruit trees are gonna be coming into the nurseries here probably within a month. And so will all the onions and the carrots and the potatoes and all those kind of roots. So once those get in, I'm gonna get all those in the ground. But at least today I'm still preparing. I'm getting the barn all cleaned up and organized. And chickens are up there. They're out today. They're just loving this weather. Why wouldn't they? I just took them a bunch of stuff from the house. And there they are, way up there playing. Yeah, they enjoy it too. All right, see what I have going here. I'm taking some of these wood chips and I'm tossing them into the this little bucket because it's getting a little bit too soft right now. All that snow just melted and the ground is too soft. I can't really get into the garden. But I noticed in front of the chicken coop, it's really, yeah, by the chicken coop door, it's really getting muddy over there. So I figured I might as well take some of this and put it around the chicken coop door and keep us, our feet from getting all muddy, all our boots getting all muddy, because that's not what it's all about. So you'll see what I mean. Let's go on up here and get this laid out. All right, that's what I was talking about. See in front of the coop there, it was really muddy. So by just putting the wood chips down, it's gonna keep us from getting all muddy and the chicken's feet a little bit cleaner, the pen a little bit cleaner. And I'm just gonna wrap this last one around this pine tree here. And that'll be better. The hens are gonna like that. And we're gonna like that. Look at it, let's see. So that's gonna be a lot better this way. Well, this is a little 2-year-old apple tree. I don't know the variety. I think it's a Jonathan Gold. And it's sort of struggled since I put it here 2 years ago. But since I put this mulch in here, or the wood chip down, just about a month ago, I'm seeing that it's changing. It's getting these little buds on it. And I hope that it's gonna make a little turnaround and get itself in shape here. I'm gonna prune it right now. It's got a lot of dead ends. You can see that. I'm gonna cut all these dead ends off back to a good bud area. Here's a brand new one right there. That wasn't there that long ago. And like this one right here. This is a good one too. This one wasn't here in the fall. But it's got a lot of bad dead ends here. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim it down with my little shears here. And I'm probably gonna bring this one all the way back to the first sign of new growth. So that's what I'm gonna do here. If I can get this thing to focus for you. Well, it doesn't have autofocus, but look at that. Now that's gonna be the new lead. I'm gonna just continue on down. especially like right in here. We have some, I'm gonna cut that off. I'm gonna follow the new growth and cut it off at that straight line of the new growth. Yeah, a lot of new growth coming in. Right here, right there. Aw, oh, this is exciting. Get this tree in shape. The ladies, they always try to help. Wherever I'm working, they all come out and try to help me out. So funny. Doing their work, moseying around the yard. I'm cleaning out the barn and they're just loving it. I'm finding leaves and a bunch of summer items and they're just all in the barn. I had to kick them out. Oh, that home back there, that was for one of the old dogs. That igloo. I'm gonna take it, put it out in the woods near the garden area and put straw in it for barn cats. We have a barn cat now, but it's in the barn. I wouldn't mind having a few barn cats because there's, you know, just keep some of these critters that are running around out here down a little bit. Plus, it's always fun having a barn cat run around. Look at them, they found some snow up here. A little bit of leftover snow. Well, if you're wondering why I don't use a standard tractor, it's because of this. This guy right here has taken place of a tractor. I had the Bobcat for all the heavy lifting and digging, but this guy right here, this little golf cart, it's I've had this for since 1998, and I put that back seat on that folds down into a little back bed there, and it was at a golf course for 2 years, and then I bought it, and now it's living the easy life here on the ranch. I like it because it's quiet. It's so much low power torque because of that electric motor. It's real heavy because of the batteries. You know, it's not going to do, obviously, it's not going to do real heavy work, but just light duty stuff around here, moving stuff from the front of the property to the back of the property. I have a little trailer that goes on the back. It's real handy. Fits in anywhere. And then, you know, it washes up really well too. And the kids, they like to take their friends on rides for it around the area. So obviously not on the main roads, we don't do that, but this guy, I'm glad I have it, and it's found a new life here on the garden. So I'm gonna go ahead and burn these stalks right now.